6,889 miles. That's the distance from San Francisco to Hong Kong. That's how far I would travel. That's how far I would travel for one thing. Well, three things in one.
But like most journeys, it didn't start there. It started way before that. This is my journey. This is my journey to G3.
I don't know what it was about wine other than it just was fascinating to me. It was this bottomless pit of information that just couldn't end. I wanted something that was going to draw me in so close and so tirelessly that I couldn't breathe. I know that's a crazy thought. It was like this thing that I knew that I would never get to the end of, and that to me more than anything was an amazing feeling. It was more than just learning about wine, it was discovering how to incorporate wine into my life. And I remember when I was taught about the Renaissance person, this person that was well-versed in life, they were evolved and educated and cultured, and I really wanted to be like that. That was something that was really important to me. Wine was sort of at the center of that. I felt like everywhere I looked, every person I admired, every woman who had done amazing things, they were seemingly just naturally knowledgeable about wine. That was very enticing. When I was growing up, my parents didn't really drink wine. I didn't know anything about wine, but I started having these doors open for me when I was living in New York. It was absolutely terrifying to walk through them, mostly because it's a tough world. I knew that I wasn't going to be welcome in it. I was okay with that. I was okay with going about things a little bit differently because I knew that I had something different to offer. I started carving my own path, and I started thinking about what it was that really drew me into wine, what it was that made me start learning about it in the first place. And
after I moved to Napa, I picked up my camera, and I started documenting everything that I was doing, that I was seeing, that I was drinking. I wanted to share what was happening, so I started to post my photos on Instagram, and then I started documenting my experiences in Napa to upload on YouTube. I knew that I had this story to tell. I knew that every wine that I was drinking and learning about, there was this inner story that I wanted to share because I felt like it wasn't being talked about. We were focusing on the points of a wine and the terroir and all of this complicated jargon that really didn't make sense to me before I started learning about it. After a while, people started to take notice of what I was doing. And a little while after that, Penfolds called. They had a big announcement in Hong Kong and they wanted me to be a part of it. I was scared. I thought, how in the world am I going to contribute to telling the story of a wine that was literally 62 years in the making?
Wine has this unbelievable ability to mark these occasions in our lives, and as we're going through our own journeys, as we're getting to where we want to go, wine for me has always sort of been a marker along the way. Each different bottle has symbolized this time and this place, and it's this tangible thing that can really make you stop and make you not only stop in that moment, but make you stop a week, a month, a year, 10 years from that moment. Take you right back to that time where you opened the bottle and you poured the glass and you tasted the wine. And for me, that was a really important thing to learn along the way, that wine wasn't just this fermented beverage. It wasn't just this thing that you consumed. It was this talisman, this thing that was iconic in my own personal life. Every wine had a different place. I remember there are certain wines along the way. There was the 87 Joseph Swan Zinfandel the night that I decided to move to Napa Valley. I remember what that tasted like. I remember what I felt when I drank that wine. There was the Ochi Pinti SP68 when I fell in love drinking that bottle. There was the Penfolds Grange the night that I realized that wine could be so much more than just grape juice. It was sort of an aha wine. And then, of course, there was the G3. And the G3 will forever mark an occasion in my life where I felt like I was validated.
I had gone down this path. I had done it my own way. I had done something that nobody else had done, that people told me I shouldn't do. And yet, here I was in Hong Kong. That was validating. And maybe that's a bad thing to say. I don't know. I've made a lot of mistakes, but I've also taken a lot of chances. And this will be a moment for me when a dream was realized. I had this dream of not only learning about wine, but doing it in my own way, carving a path that was uniquely mine that nobody else had done before.
This journey is difficult and tiresome, but it's my journey and it's incredible. It feels good every day. I wake up every single day surrounded by vineyards and winemakers and people who are passionate about what they do. Now I get to be in this place where I get to drink this wine, this 1,200 bottle produced wine of 3 vintages of Grange, which only a handful of people in the world will get to taste. And this moment will always be special. This moment, even now, after the fact, will always feel incredible, even thinking back on it. That's what wine does, and why I love wine, because it doesn't matter if I'm standing in the bathroom getting ready, it doesn't matter if I'm standing in the middle of a vineyard in Napa Valley. Whenever I think of the G3, it will take me back to Hong Kong, it will take me back to that night, it will take me back to that feeling.
I think we'll ever be expected at this size that we'll taste this wine as we are here this evening. So the Penfolds is historic. It's nothing like the 8, it's nothing like the 12, and believe me, it will be nothing like the 14. But we're terribly excited by the wine. A little bit of courageous, a little bit of silliness, a little bit of lots of things. But it is what it is. It is real. It's G3, and we are extremely proud of the Penfolds. This is it. Thank you.
This is a really big moment. This is the first time that I'm getting to taste the Penfolds G3. And the G3 is a blend of 3 Grange vintages, the 2008, the 2012, and the 2014. So let's take it to taste it. I remember the first time I had Grange, and the memories they're coming back. And This is everything that I had hoped the wine would be, but it's also everything that I know wine can do. And for me, wine evokes something so much deeper than anything else. It evokes a time and a place and memories, and it attacks your senses in ways that other things can't, ways that music can't penetrate it. It's like it goes into your nose and right into your soul. I will never forget the first time that I saw this. That's incredible. I'm gonna be about 5 minutes while this finishes on my palate.